The Paul Leslie Hour, helping people tell their stories. And now, your host, Paul Leslie.
Hey, it's me. Thank you, as always, for joining us here on the Paul Leslie Hour. Great to have you tuned in. If you would like to support the show, you are more than welcome to do so. Go to patreon.com/thePaulLeslieHour. As you know, I have quite an extensive archive of interviews. There are still probably a few hundred that are waiting to come out. 2019 is the 50th anniversary of the rock band Little Feat. I don't know if there is any rock band that I have seen in concert more than Little Feat. They just have that indescribable sound. They somehow manage to be rock music, but you could kind of imagine this rock music taking place in a barn. I don't know if that makes sense, but that's how I see them. Very laid back, very cool. One of the people who used to be in Little Feat is Shaun Murphy. Now, this is the first in a 7-part series where I interviewed all of the members of Little Feat. The first one was with Shaun, I think. This is the first one in the series, and it's a very short interview. There's a couple of reasons for this. I made the request to do the interview. They got back to me right before the show and said, "Hey, we didn't think that we would have time to do this, but can you come now?" So I went to the venue. This was at the Melting Point in Athens, Georgia. I got to go on the Little Feat tour bus, which was very cool. You're going to hear something slightly off in my voice. I was a little sick. I can remember that day very well, so you're probably going to notice there's something off with my voice. But Shaun Murphy was very, very sweet. She made me some brownies. That doesn't happen every day. I can remember that well in Athens, Georgia. She has quite a story. Shaun Murphy has performed with just about everybody, in addition to Little Feat. Bob Seger, Glenn Frey, Joe Walsh, Bruce Hornsby, even Alice Cooper. A lot of you are familiar with the album that she made with Meat Loaf that was called Stoney and Meat Loaf. Well, Shaun Murphy is Stoney. These days, Shaun Murphy is the leader of her own band, the Shaun Murphy Band. She left Little Feat in 2009. Nonetheless, it's my pleasure to present this interview that we recorded prior to one of their very exciting shows in Athens, Georgia, back in 2008. Enjoy.
It is our extreme pleasure to welcome Shaun Murphy from Little Feat on our program today. We do appreciate your taking the time to take a minute to talk to us. Welcome to the program.
Thanks, Paul. It's great to see you.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, you are the newest member of Little Feat.
Yes, it is. I've joined the band in 1993.
One of the things that blew me away, you had performed with Meat Loaf.
Yeah, we were actually in a version of Hair together, and Motown came and saw us, and even though we didn't have any scenes together in the play, they put us together and we put out a record in 1970.
How did you discover Little Feat?
When I first moved to Los Angeles in 1972, they were playing a couple of their songs on the radio all the time, and then I kind of followed the band now and again, and of course I lost track of them. Obviously, I didn't know that Lowell had passed in 1979, but I had the fortunate chance to meet up with Fred Tackett and Bill Payne on the 1986 tour with Bob Seger, who I'd been working with off and on since 73. At that point, Bob thought it was going to be his farewell tour, so he wanted to add some people that he'd been in the studio with but, you know, hadn't actually toured with. So he had contacted Bill and Fred and asked them if they would come out and tour. So that's how I met them. And when the band reformed in 87, they put a record out, the Let It Roll album in 88, and they asked Bob and I to come and do some backgrounds for them on that record.
And the Little Feat has been around a lot of years. What do you think it is about Little Feat that it's been alive for so long and it still manages to draw a crowd and everyone just seems to still love them? It's not many bands that have an opportunity to tour for so long.
Well, you know, it's not just the music about chicks and cars, but I think it's just a general feel-good music altogether. And I think people have to dig a little bit more to find the band, listen to the music, than they would anything that's current on the radio. So anything you have to work for, then you appreciate it more, I guess. I don't know. But the fans have been really, really loyal throughout, you know, even the hiatus period. So it's just good American music.
What do you think it is about Little Feat that is different from other kinds of music or other bands that are out there? Because I know, I mean, you don't see many bands, well, you do on this program, but you don't see many bands with conga drums, and you don't really have many bands that are going that far out on the limb. So I was just going to ask, what do you think it is about Little Feat that sets it apart from other bands?
Well, I think the appeal that we have is a little more widespread because we can reach anybody from age, you know, I don't know, little kids on up to grandparents, because we have a plethora of different genres of music, and the appeal is so widespread, you know. And everybody's very good players in the band, so that doesn't hurt either.
Where do you see Little Feat going? It's been such a long time since Little Feat started. Do you view many years coming down the pike? What do you think's going to happen with Little Feat?
Well, I think we've got a lot of music left in us, and we want to explore all kinds of avenues, and we've got a new record coming out, hopefully this summer, a new studio record. Can't give you any definite dates on that. It's still not finished, but it should be a pretty special record. We've got a lot of special guests on it, and we just keep going. I mean, you know, we love to play, we love to write, and we love to record, so I hopefully I don't see any end to it.
I do appreciate you taking the time to talk to me. It's been a pleasure having you on the program. I do have one more question for you. Since this program does go out all over the world, what would you, Shaun Murphy of Little Feat, like to say to the world?
Wow, that's a big chunk, boy. Gosh, I don't know. I guess, you know, we're just in this life all together, and we should all just try and help each other out a little bit more and pay attention to what's going on in the world and spread a little more love.
Well, I do appreciate you taking the time to talk to me, and I know this is going to be a great show.
We're looking forward to it. We always have a great time here in Athens, Georgia.
All right. Well, thank you so much.
Thanks, Paul.
A bop, bop, deely, bop, bop, ba-doo, bop, zee, bock, a doodly, not bock, seeky, cha, cha, cook, a boz, a look, a boz, a neck, a pork, a get a go, da, dum. Pop to the sun, but over decky party, yeah. A zika baka puka, don't go, doodle, looky dee boo, goodbye.